Well, hello everybody. Today we've got a surprise for you. We're going to do a review, just a quick review basically, on the brand new President Washington 10 meter radio that just came out. So there's the box, and as you can see, the radio sitting down there below us. Give me just a second and we'll get started on this review. Well, so as you can see here, this radio is full featured. We've got just a quick run through of some of the buttons that are on the front. Of course, you've got your volume, your squelch, which is normal. You've got your mode button down here. That's going to be for your, zoom in a little bit, that's going to be for your sideband AM, FM, memory channels, scan, your noise blankers, emergency channel, channel 9, your band selector. You've got your Vox, noise reduction set, TX-RX, that's going to be for your clarifier. You've got echo and talkback, function and lock. You've got your volume, or channel selector, I'm sorry, and your clarifier. Okay? Now there's multi-functions for this. You've got high cut filters, you've got your mic gain control here, you've got your RF power control that you're done through here. We're not going to get into a lot of that stuff. I'm sure there'll be 100 videos out there that's doing great in-depth videos on that. What I want to show you is the radio itself, and I want to give you a quick rundown of the circuitry inside. So I'll tell you what, give me just a minute. We're going to get the covers off and we'll be back. Okay, we got the covers off. First off, we'll just give you a quick scan of the backside. There's nothing really to see. It is interesting that they put a big heavy shield over the transmit section over here, the RF section. It's kind of interesting. But other than that, not a lot to see there. So let's show you what the other side looks like. There's a little more interesting things here. Okay, so here we are looking at the guts of the radio, so to speak. So first off, we're going to spin it around. And I want to bring your attention over here. This is the audio chip. And the audio chip is using the standard audio chip, TDA 2003. However, let me flip the radio over and show you something. If you look, here's the legs of the audio chip, and you'll notice they're all in a row. The chip's not bent like the normal chip is, so that's something that they've changed. Those are just absolutely straight. So that's interesting. Mounted with a nut and a bolt. There is heatsink compound on it. There's your AM regulator, just standard AM regulator, nothing special there. Okay. Oops, going the wrong way with my gizmo. We'll start out looking here. This wiring here that runs up to this board in the back, let me go ahead and zoom in on that a little bit. That's going to be for your fans, and as you can see, you've got two different spots to plug your fans in. The back case is slotted for the wires to go out, and if you'll notice on your heatsink, it's already drilled and tapped for your fan kits to screw right on. So that's kind of a neat feature. This is our final section. Oops. You guys are probably going to get seasick. We're using the RF 520 finals. And as you can see, you've got your pre-driver, driver, final, and then your two outputs. Okay. Now, one of the things that we're going to talk about here is this big board that's sticking up. Okay? It's got some inductors on it. It's got a couple transistor ICs on it for power management. There's a voltage regulator down here. Okay? You've got an IC here that's got a heatsink on it. And up, there's another IC right here. You can see it. Let me zoom up a little. See it there? Okay, this is your automatic power management. It's kind of a regulator. It checks SWR. It handles the current flow for the transistors. It's kind of interesting. Something I haven't really messed with a lot yet, but I know it does several different functions. It is heavy, as you can see. And that's what another function that I want to talk to you about this radio. This radio draws some pretty good amperage. I think the box says it's 6 amps, but I'm thinking closer to 10 amp draw anyway. Especially if you do the mod. You know, this radio does, they say 80 watts. This one, if with the RF power all the way up, hold on, the phone's ringing. Okay, sorry. Well, I forgot what I was saying now. It's called Old Age 101. I'm just talking about the power draw. This thing draws a pretty good amount of power. So, absolutely no cigarette lighter plug. I would say it's going to draw somewhere around 10 amps. With the modification done to this radio, you're going to see around 110 watts or so. Without the modification, 70, 75 watts. Okay. I've already figured out the modification to get the 110 watts. I have not done the low power mod. You're going to get about 50 watts out of it from a low dead key. When you turn to get the RF power up, you're going to see that 110 watts. One other thing that I want to talk about is the power cord that comes with this radio. It is not a heavy duty power cord, and I would suggest that you upgrade your power cord at least to the 12 gauge power cord. That's going to make a difference. Cut your wires off as short as possible, because this radio does draw some amperage. Conversion is very straightforward on it. Not a big deal at all to get it converted. But from what I understand, this radio is not available to anyone other than dealers, so they'll be most likely converted when you buy them, which is a good thing. One of the bad things about the conversion process on this radio is the holes are already filled with solder, so you're going to have to desolder the holes to be able to do the jumper mod. It's not a big deal. I can show you. Maybe, as soon as I find it. Here it is. Okay, so you can see right here that this is a conversion. You have to put a jumper across there. Not a problem, other than you can also see from the other holes that they're filled with solder, which means you've got to get that solder out of there, and you need to be really careful with the board as far as making sure you don't tear up the traces or overheat the traces when you do that. So that takes care of that. Okay guys, other than that, like I said, this radio's got tons of features in the front, and I'm sure there'll be some guys doing some great videos showing you every feature and how they work. I wanted to give you a heads up about the radio, the internals of the radio, let you see the radio firsthand, see the circuit board firsthand. I can tell you that it does a great job. Matter of fact, what I'll do is I'll hook it up, and I want you to see the wattage, and you can see the scope pattern on it. So give me just a minute, we'll be right back, and we'll show you that. Okay guys, we're back. We've got the radio on, as you can see, and we're going to show you how it is stock right out of the box. This is going to be our power. You can go over here, let me see if I can get the glare off this meter. We're on the 100 watt scale, so that's going to be your bottom scale on the meter. Let's go ahead and key this dude up. Let me get you up here a little closer. About 75. There's your pattern. Okay, give me just a minute. We're going to do our modification, and I'll be right back and show you what we get. All right, guys, we're back, and we've done the modification to the radio. Show you what we get now. She's slapping that 100 watt scale completely over. Let's look at the scope pattern. That should make most of the purists happy. We've got a good pattern. We've got good audio. And we've got good wattage. So guys, in short, that's the gist of it. I guess we could put it on sideband. Let's see what happens. Let's check it out on sideband. We could if the mic plug hadn't fell out. Give me just a minute. There we go. All right, here we are. We're on sideband. Audio, 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 audio. Hello, audio. 1, 2. Audio, audio, audio. 1, 2, 3, 4. Audio test. Audio test. Audio test. Hello. Well, there you go, guys. Now you've seen it. This is the President Washington 10-meter radio, brand new out from President. I think it's going to have a lot of potential. This is first look at it. I wanted you guys to get a chance to see it and see what you thought. See what you if you like the looks of it, if you like the way it operates. It's got a great receiver as well, as far as that goes. Well, let's hook it up. I'll tell you what, give me a minute, guys. We'll hook the receiver up and let you hear it. Hold on just a second. We'll be right back. Okay, guys, we're back. We've got the radio on. Let's see if we can... see what's going on in the bowl. Well, I thought we'd get more people there than that. Nobody talking when you want to hear somebody. Well, I'll tell you what let's do. Let me show you. We're going to go ahead and turn off the noise blankers. That's everything off.
Yeah, that's something to call me on the phone this morning.
There we go.
We got him set up.
Anti-noise blanker on.
He called me from California this morning.
Noise blanker. There's both. Let's go ahead and turn the noise reduction on. Hear how quiet that is?
Well, I'm sure you'll hear him sometime in the very near future. 8231, catch you later. I'm getting down.
Let's turn the noise reduction off. Back on. And by the way, guys, that noise reduction is set to 1. That's just on the first setting. To give you an idea. See how quiet that radio is?
But I am a little educated down here, Cat Pig. I do got 3 degrees on that Cat Pig in, and get a little bit of higher education. They probably wouldn't appreciate me talking like I'm talking right along through up in here. You know, kind of like this here. They'd be like, what in the world is happening?
All right, guys. Well, there you have it. You've got a quick look at the new President Washington. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please like, please subscribe. We're going to do more videos on this radio, obviously, when we get a little further along. I just want you guys to have a chance to see it. If you're interested in obtaining this radio, we have them in the website. Just go to customcbradios.com. You can buy this radio. We can set it up. We can do the modifications for it and get it out to you rather quickly. So, guys... this is CB Repair Guy. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, get a hold of me. If you need any repair work done, get a hold of us. We're doing repair work here, and we do all different types of brands of radios. So, other than that, I don't have anything else for you guys. I hope you, like I said, I hope you enjoyed this. That's about the third time I said it, so I really hope you did. You guys have a good day. Until the next video, so long.